Uma. You know how long it took for Ugandans to understand that you're saying, would you mind? It's like, was Namwa Juma, na Juma, Wujuma, Wujuma. Oh my God! Whew, child! Josephine, now turn this call up until we have a Uganda call like a wedding. I bet you this is just going to come out like. Kankwagale. I can't even for the life of me. Awata Nachimanya. Today is Rehman Namakulas. Kwanjula Yanjulo Mwami Dr. Sebunya Hamza Banange. Woo! Chiri Wad. Chiri Kampala. The sima in a bagamba because as of now, when I'm coming on air, it's in the evening. Naemi sana tuba de tuli monsa sage yo ka. Then sasage for sensa sage. Banange. Omkoya tu said da. Woo! Jesus! I can't wait to do this story tomorrow because as of today, we can't do much. They refused. From every media house, they only allowed, I think, one camera person. It's only Bukede that actually could have gotten like about three because we're big like that. And yeah, it's interesting. Okwanjula kuliwona bingo. I always like to first sit down and watch. But yeah, it's going down today. The happy couple seems to be in very good moods. I saw Hamza. He was all tealed out. He was wearing teal and kanzu. The same old boring stuff that men have to wear. It's the ladies that we always get interested to look at. But I will not say much. Every blogger is running around like a headless chicken. Others have opened up Snapchat accounts just to have the live feed for those who are going to be inside, given you can't see much. Mm-hmm. I'm like, okay, so after the Kwanjula, then the wedding, right? Then after the wedding, what happens again, Josephine? After the wedding. Anyway, I just wanted to say it's going to be interesting. And I've been so lucky with this whole Rema situation. I haven't really tried to go so deep into it because I already have way too many people in those camps. And we're just waiting for a mycology gwe to be wishing good luck. Then to turn, all you need to know is that we are happy, that they are happy. Muninde nchandio kemba totole bandanga banda bono nye sete. Ndoza na kuagalana ze yaba wa 500 million intono. Ntono. Olabi omudalo ogwo. Half of you women muli yo katibuli kwe kubia mizimu. Nange baino kuntu alanga rema tulo kalide we sulisetelea. Olirema. But like seriously. We didn't even make this much noise about Komuntale's wedding. And she was royalty. Do you think we'll even make half of this noise when what's her name? Princess Nkizi is getting married to Gareth Onyango. Do you think? And they are royalty. Okay, maybe. Okay, you have to remember, Rema is royalty. Wait, when an introduction? My name is Tina VS1. Welcome to Skabonsk. Bitch. I'm not really going to talk much about Rema's introduction. I want to first watch it in all its entirety. And then, yeah, but what's there to say? What's there to talk about at the end of the day? It's the same issue that happens at every mukolo, every kwanjula. There's always a loudmouth auntie, a loudmouth grandparent. There's always good food. There's always good clothes. The decor is good. It's basically just a moment of people just going, ooh, ah. I don't expect anything bad. Come on. Kwamanya chiri na bingo gwe. Love nigga ya follow me. Tariyo. Where were we, Josephine? Today the story wasn't supposed to be Reba's kwajula, even if it's her kwajula. So you see, there are times when I plan on not being petty. There are times when I wake up and I just want to be nice to people. And I just want to sit and talk, have a decent argument with people. You know, just do what good people do. You know, live life. Then ne wavaye yo mtu. Na kubwogera gasia. No mtunuli aboti no gamba. Oluzungu lwe ruzibu. of all Uganda and Kendism. So today morning, I'm standing outside my TV station. I was actually on set. And then this guy walks up to me and he's like, oh, hey, T, I'm a fan. I watch the show. Then he goes like, "Na yere kira uko gera kubi into be a politics, especially people power and all of that." I'm like, look here. This is what my platform does. If you are not comfortable with it, please tell you and your friends and their friends who follow the same ideology that doesn't have to be talked about to go to another platform that they can agree with. Because you people need to understand, just because I do not agree to your ideology does not mean I do not have to like you. I listened to this cat and I asked him simple basic questions about his political affiliation. And I told him, look here, me, I'm non-partisan. I'm still looking for someone who represents my interests. But then Norabo Musajjo Mukuru Ngoyo Najana Ngamba, no T, why we're saying this is because your platform is discouraging the youth. That is when I was like, the fuck did this idiot smoke? What did you smoke? It's simple. It's social media. The people that understand what I am trying to say will stay. If you don't agree with an opinion, leave. Tewebo besa mitwe. Like, as though that wasn't bad enough, he finna tell me that, no, this is what we need you to do. You need to, like, get all that following to so that you can stop misleading the youth. I'm like, who died and made these people this? Chigambo chiganye no gun. So I should speak of your ideology because you feel bothered by the fact that I am opinionated enough to have my own ideology. You don't even just stop at that. You want me to put my thoughts on the side and carry yours, whether I believe them or not believe them. Now you see, this is why, for me, it's going to take a minute. Like, the hierarchy in people power may at some point make sense to me, but this is going to take us a very long time that we don't have for people power supporters to understand the entirety of politics. Politics is not just about sentiment. Politics is not just about, oh my goodness, I feel some type of way. And I asked him something simple. I'm like, okay, let's try to buy into your ideology, okay? Right. So you want Museveni to go, yeah, tumkoye, that impunity. I'm like, very good, me too. I feel like I need change. So what are you going, what's your plan after he is gone? When you oust him, Just give me a 5-year plan. And then he goes, it's like, yeah, we are going to take back these institutions and the impunity will stop. I'm like, that's it? You do know that running a nation is not just one-sided, that it's just the politicking. There's a lot that goes into that politics. There's the economy, there's security, there's thinking forward for a nation to almost like about 10-year plans and 100-year plans. So if you're giving me a mandate and that is not covered according to me, and I decide, you know what, I will not buy into your ideology because you do not represent the kind of Uganda I want. Why does it hurt Omuntu Omulala Ali Kululuolwe? Nagamba, no, just because you do not understand it doesn't mean you don't have to go with it. What's that, Nyokori? You people, and that's the problem. It's because it's the youth, anyway. You like to see things on the surface. You never actually... Do you know your political history from way before independence? Do you? Do you know that some of the things you're facing now are repercussions of things that were not even done in Museveni's regime, but regimes earlier on? Do you know that... See, that's why I like listening to politicians, because they teach you a lot. They give you an option of where to fall. Decide. And right now, I am on Mugisha Muntu's team, because he seems like the only logical person who can stand up and he said one thing. Tagging this man out of power is not the problem. But what is life post Museveni or after Museveni? What plan do you have? You need to pick a leader, whichever one you decide, you need to pick a leader who represents your, who represents your ideologies, your thoughts, who represents what you want to stand for, who represents what you want your kids to find. Because us, we are suffering because, well, we pretty much let our parents make the decision for us and they put Museveni in power. Now it's our chance to decide the next pretty much, I don't know, century of this country. Don't just do it out of sentiment and public opinion because the public is following. No. What do you want your president to be like? What do you want your leader to be like? What do you want the next government to be like? Don't go with Kayola. Then you'll understand politics. I saw someone post a video of Jack Pemba arriving at the airport and I'm like, wait, what? This... Why are we giving Jack Pemba time to try nembaga ya re matulinze kenza demwa kabenga bamtwala to China politics to China ba bit to China ba face to ine bintu binji vetu ino kubanga to take a ko camera. Why are we doing this for a fraudster, a fraudulent human being? Why? Mbui has been gone for a year. Now he's coming back. The parties he supports are happy. I was like, of course they are. Anyway, did he finally pay his debts off? Akwagala nabali bamubanja naye olaba akomyewo with such pomp and glam. Yali agenze kuba balala ku mitwe yazisasudde. So yes, it's official people. December ya kunafuyizibwa. Tugenda jinafuya. January tujigezese that was summer starting to come. The crazies are coming to town. Hey!
Someone needs to tell Nina Rose not to wear socks and short dresses. Like, her legs are just... you know, like when they say she has nice long legs? Because Nina is really tall, but...
I was even going to say something about Catherine and her whole situation with wearing a UPDF uniform, which is pissing each and every one off. Right now, I'm sitting there like... But as of today morning, they clarified, they're like, Bulichisa gwetuwa uoluku soku zambala. Bagenda ziba bajako. That is, of course, for Katolu Bwama, Catherine Kusasira. Bulichisa ajirina, like... Things that my government does, and I'm like, you know what? I can't even. I won't even. I just cannot. @TinaPS1 is my Twitter handle, and on Facebook, we are Scoop and Scoop, and at Twitter, we are Scoop and Scoop, and at TinaPS1. And on Instagram, it's @TinaPS1 with an H. Not forgetting on Snapchat, it's @TinaPS. Now, Snapchat is lit. I have finally kind of learned how to work it. Woo wee! I'm having a blast. I'm out. Peace.